جايين من كل مكان للصويرة زينة البلدان زورون رجع فرحان كفى بينو للهلولة حط السلاح وطوم حيلة ضربو شوفار هاد الليلة
شالوم وبركة. I would like to wish to all of you حق سماح. As you know, the Shabbat is Shabbat Gadol. The Shabbat Gadol, it was something that happened when our parents, they were in Egypt. And the biggest miracle of all miracles was that at that Shabbat Gadol, Hashem asked from the Jews to take the Avodah Zarah of the Egyptian. You know, at that time, the Egyptian were not allowed to eat meat. And even the Jewish people in Egypt, they couldn't eat meat because they cannot kill it, because the Egyptian, it was their idolatry. It was not possible to dream, to think, to do that. And Hashem said to the Bnei Israel, to the Jews, the only way that I will deliver you from Egypt, it's by taking the God, the Egyptian God, that was a sheep at that time, and to take it. And if they ask you, the Egyptian, what you're doing, you tell them, this, we're going to do our feast before we leave Egypt. We will kill it, we will eat it. So the Egyptian, they were very, very angry when they saw the Bnei Israel doing that. I mean, the miracle was that the Egyptians, they could kill them on the Shabbat HaGadol, and they couldn't do it. So it was very important for Hashem that the Bnei Israel, they would see that the Egyptian God has no powerful, he's not powerful, he is nothing, he's weak. I mean, the Egyptians at the time, they believed so strongly of that kind of good, the goodness, you know, that the sheep were very holy. Now, the Bnei Israel showed them that there is nothing and their God. It's just an animal. And then the Bnei Israel, they realized before they left Egypt that there is only Hashem. Hashem, it was very important for him that the Bnei Israel will see that. So, once they leave Egypt, they will not have the thought that there is something in the Egyptian God. That was there, and this is the reason as well why before the Bnei Israel left Egypt, Hashem killed all the Egyptian firstborn. Why? Because at that time, the Egyptian, they believed that all firstborn is like God. He has something of God in each firstborn. So Hashem wanted to show the Bnei Israel that, and he wanted to show to the Egyptian that what they believe on, it's not God. The proof, I left only the Jewish firstborn and the Egyptian firstborn, Akash Baruch Hu, he killed them that night. So that means Hashem, he showed the Bnei Israel before they left Egypt how he avenged his glory, how he showed to the Egyptian that their God is nothing. The sheep, it's nothing, and the Bechorim, the firstborn, it's nothing. It's only a human being, and they just they consider them as idolatry, and they have nothing, no powerful, nothing. This is the reason why we call it Shabbat HaGadol. Shabbat HaGadol is the big Shabbos, the big Shabbat that the Bnei Israel realize there is only Hashem. That Hashem is the only one who is God. So that is the first time in their life that they saw this, because during the 400 years that they were still in Egypt, they were scared of the Egyptian. They, after so much years, they started to believe that Pharaoh is God. They started to believe that the sheep is the God. They started to believe that even the the firstborn is God. And now they see that there is only Hashem, that all this God that the Egyptian consider that it's God, it's nothing. I'm not powerful at nothing. So now maybe you will ask me a question. Why the Jewish people, all the firstborn, they have to fast before Pesach, you know, the 14th day of Nisan, all the firstborn, Jewish firstborn, they fast. They have to fast. But if there is a Siyum and there is a Seudah, they don't fast. I mean, I think they should not fast. You know why? Because if they should do a feast. They should be, they should do, a party. Why? Because Baruch Hashem, they didn't die. It's a miracle. So they have to be happy. I mean, every time that there is a miracle, we don't fast. When a miracle happens to us, we do Shechianu, we do a holiday, we do a festival, we do something. So I think the Jewish firstborn, they should do a Seudah. Why they have to fast? You know why? Because some of them, maybe some of them, they were afraid. Maybe they will die. And maybe Hashem, he will forget one Jewish firstborn and he will die at the night of Pesach. Because what it is Pesach? Pesach is jump. Hashem, he jumped the Jewish home and he did not jump the Egyptian home. That means that the Jewish home, all the firstborn that they were there, all Jewish firstborn that were there, they did not die. They died only Egyptian firstborn. But there were some Jewish people. They said, maybe Hashem, he will not jump our house. Maybe Hashem, he will not jump to the house. So Hashem, he was not fair. He said, okay, I forgive you. But the punishment that I give you is that you will fast the day of one day before Pesach. You will, all the first day we should pray. But you can cancel your fast if there is a Seudat Mitzvah. So my friend, this is the reason why we fast some firstborn. All Jewish firstborn have to fast the day of Pesach. No, one day before Pesach, because we are not allowed to fast on Yom Tov. So they fast one day before Pesach, but they can buy the fast with a Seudat Mitzvah. My friend, now you understand why it's Shabbat Gadol. And Shabbat Gadol, it's a hope. Maybe we'll see Mashiach. Ah, yes. But the Jewish people, their delivery started on the 10th of Nisan. You know, on Shabbat Gadol, the miracle start. Why? Because they were, Baruch Hashem, they were out the 14th of Nisan. The 15th of Nisan, pardon. They were out of Egypt. But at the 10th of Nisan, every Jew took the sheep. So by taking the sheep and telling the Egyptians that they can do Shechita to that ship, so the miracle started from that day. And that was on Shabbat HaGadol. So my friend, the miracle started on Shabbat HaGadol. So Be'et Hashem, maybe our miracle will start on Shabbat HaGadol, and after Shabbat HaGadol, Mashiach will come. Who knows? Anyway, I would like to wish to all of you happiness, bracha, v'atzlacha. Our friends from Costa Rica, our friends from Mexico, our friends from Brazil, and our friends from New York, from the United States, and of course our friends from Argentina, with all the people that we know all over the world. This is a message of hope, a message of blessing, a message that Hashem will give you all what you need. Parnasa tova, refuah shelema. It's very important, this Shabbat. Very, very important. You know, it's a Shabbat, that's what we call it, the big Shabbat. Shabbat HaGadol. Because for the Jews in Egypt 3,500 years ago, it was a big, big, big Shabbat. It was a Shabbat of suspense, a Shabbat that maybe the Egyptian will kill us. It was a Shabbat terrible, but they saw miracles that Shabbat. They started to believe. Now really they believe that Hashem is going to deliver them after Shabbat HaGadol. When they saw that the Egyptian, you couldn't do nothing to them, when they took their God, their idolatry, and they declare to them that they can do a shechita to this and to grill it and to eat it, well, that was really that was the open door for the delivery. And besides this, before they went out from Egypt, they did the Brit Milah. Well, they knew that they can do the Brit Milah because they will not leave Egypt without doing the Brit Milah. So because to leave Egypt, they had to leave Egypt as a holy people. And how they were holy? By doing the Shechita of the Egyptian god. At that time, it was the sheep, and doing the Brit Milah, eating matzah, they get rid of the chametz, of the ga'ava, they did a big teshuva. Well, my friend, Be'ezat Hashem, we hope Be'ezat Hashem soon, we'll see Mashiach. Amen. Hashem bless you. Thank you very much.